Hello friends, today's topic of discussion is passive transport. It is one of the type of transport across the cell membrane. Transport across the cell membrane is divided into three main types. First one is the passive transport, second one is the active transport, and third one is the vesicular transport. Today's topic of discussion is passive transport, and you may get short note on this topic. Active transport is also a short note in university examination, and transport across the cell membrane, it is a LAQ. What is the meaning of passive transport? Passive transport means transport of molecule across the membrane down the concentration gradient. Down the concentration gradient means from higher concentration to lower concentration. And for this process, energy is not required. This passive transport is divided into four main types: simple diffusion, facilitated diffusion, osmosis, and filtration. These are the four main types of passive transport. So coming to the simple diffusion, okay, means transport of molecule down the concentration gradient. In simple diffusion, it is the transport of molecule down the concentration gradient, and energy requirement is not here. In simple, all types of passive transport, energy requirement is not there. And carrier proteins, whether it is carrier mediated or not, the carrier proteins are not required for the simple diffusion. It is a simple transport of molecule across the membrane from higher concentration to lower concentration. Now, there are two mechanisms of transport in the simple diffusion. How many? Two mechanisms. The first one is the transport of lipid soluble compounds, and second one is the transport of ions. These are the two mechanisms. The first one is transport of lipid soluble compound, mainly gases and urea. It is transported through the lipid bilayer. Because it is soluble in lipid, it can travel through the membrane. So there is transport of this urea or oxygen from higher concentration to lower concentration across the membrane because it is soluble in lipid. This is the first mechanism in simple diffusion. And second, through ion channels. This is an ion channel. And through this ion channel, transport of ions occur because of charge, the ion cannot transport through the lipid bilayer. Okay, so ion channels are there. Number of examples of ion channels are sodium channels, potassium channel, calcium channel, chloride channels. These are the ion channels. Okay, and there are two types of ion channels. First one is the, so two mechanisms are there in simple diffusion. Simple diffusion, two mechanisms. First, lipid soluble compounds transported directly from higher concentration to lower concentration, and second one is the ion channels. These ion channels is of two types. The first one is the voltage gated, and second one is the ligand gated. Okay. Voltage gated ion channels means opening and closing of these channels are dependent on charge developed across the membrane. It is dependent on charge developed across the membrane. These are the example. Voltage gated sodium channels. Okay. And opening and closing of the channels, when it is dependent on chemical, it is known as ligand. Ligand gated. The main ligands are acetylcholine and glutamate. Okay, these are the chemicals by which opening and closing of the ion channels occurs. So there are two types: voltage gated ion channels and ligand gated ion channels. The example of ion channels are sodium, potassium, calcium, and chloride. So in simple diffusion, two mechanisms. The lipid soluble compounds, example urea, oxygen. The ion channels, example sodium, potassium, chloride. calcium. These are the examples of ion channels. Now, clinical application related to the simple diffusion is clinical significance or clinical application is. The first one is the chloride channels. Okay, there is mutation in the chloride channels. There is mutation in the CFTR, that is CFTR. Mutation in CFTR gene, that is cystic fibrosis transmembrane conductance regulator gene. Cystic fibrosis transmembrane regulator gene. Mutation in this gene causes the defect in the chloride channels. Okay, which causes cystic fibrosis. This is one clinical significance of this simple diffusion. Second one is the various drugs which are used in the treatment of hypertension and diabetes. They affect the ion channels. Various drugs used in the treatment of hypertension and diabetes mellitus, they affect the ion channels. For example, sulfonylurease. Sulfonylurease is an oral anti-diabetic drug which is used in the treatment of diabetes. It causes closure of potassium channels. Which is responsible for release of insulin from isolates of Langerhans of pancreas. Okay, so these are the two clinical significance related with simple diffusion. Now coming to the facilitated diffusion. The only difference in between simple and facilitated diffusion is carrier. Carrier protein is needed. It is a carrier mediated transport. Facilitated diffusion is carrier mediated transport. It is down the concentration gradient, means from higher concentration to lower concentration, energy is not required for this process, and carrier proteins, they are required in the facilitated diffusion. Okay, and mechanism of transport, mainly facilitated diffusion follows the ping pong mechanism. Okay, so this carrier protein, they exist in pong state, means accepting mode. Okay, this is the accepting mode or pong state. The molecules to be transported across the membrane is attached on the external part of this carrier protein. Okay, and due to the when it is attached to the external part of carrier protein, the conformational change in the protein occurs. This is the ping state. This is the pong state, means accepting mode and then release mode. It is the conformational change in the protein occurs due to which this molecules get internalized. So it is a transport down the concentration gradient, means from higher concentration to lower concentration via the carrier mediated proteins. Energy is not required for this process. When the facilitated diffusion occurs, when it is across the membrane of one component only or one molecule only, it is known as uniport. Transport of single molecule across the membrane. And when the two molecules are involved and they are transported in opposite direction, it is known as antiport. These are also types of active transport. These are uniport, simport and antiport. These are the types of active transport. But here the transport occurs down the concentration gradient, means from higher concentration to lower concentration without utilization of energy. That's why it is under the facilitated diffusion. Okay, the example of uniport facilitated diffusion is absorption of fructose from the intestine, and transport of glucose. In skeletal muscle and adipose tissue. Transport of glucose from skeletal muscle and adipose tissue. It is an insulin mediated transport. Okay. It is insulin mediated transport of glucose in skeletal muscle and adipose tissue. It is a type of uniport facilitated diffusion. okay, and the antiport example is, in facilitated diffusion example is chloride bicarbonate exchanger, chloride bicarbonate exchanger, which is present in gastrointestinal system in the stomach. It is present in the stomach and which is responsible for HCl secretion from the stomach. And second one is the bicarbonate chloride shift, that is chloride shift in RBCs. These are the two example of facilitated diffusion. Okay, so this is all about simple diffusion and facilitated diffusion. Now osmosis, what is the meaning of osmosis? Here the movement of solute occurs. In simple diffusion and facilitated diffusion there is movement of solute, but in osmosis there is movement of solvent. This is osmosis. Now look, this is the solution with lower concentration, this is the solution with higher concentration of solute. This red indicates solute and this blue indicates solvent, okay, or water. So this is the solution with lower concentration of solute, solution with higher concentration of solute, okay. Now in osmosis what occurs, this movement of solvent means blue, movement of solvent occurs, here the movement of solvent occurs towards the solution with higher concentration, towards the solution with higher concentration of solutes, okay, that is known as osmosis, okay. And osmosis, the clinical importance of osmosis is, the first one is the edema. The clinical importance of osmosis, first one is edema. Edema occurs whenever albumin concentration decreases. Okay, when albumin concentration decreases, means hypoalbuminemia occurs in some diseases, for example nephrotic syndrome and cirrhosis of liver, albumin concentration decreases, that causes decrease in plasma oncotic pressure. Decrease in plasma oncotic pressure, which is responsible for pulling of fluids into the capillaries. Okay, due to the decrease in albumin, as oncotic pressure decreases and fluids accumulate in the interstitial spaces. It accumulates in the interstitial spaces, that causes edema. It is due to osmosis. Okay, second, edema, that is due to decreased albumin level, decrease in plasma oncotic pressure, oncotic pressure, which is responsible for pulling of fluids into the capillaries. Because of decrease in oncotic pressure, the fluid accumulates in the interstitial spaces, that causes edema. This is the first in osmosis clinical application. Second, we give 0.9% normal saline in fluid loss. We give 0.9% of normal saline in fluid loss. It is a isotonic saline. Isotonic saline. When this NS is given, isotonic saline is given, RBC hemolysis does not occur because this is a isotonic solution. Okay, and when we give, for example, in the treatment of cerebral edema, we give mannitol, which is hypertonic. It is in cerebral edema. Cerebral edema. Edema. We give hypertonic saline. Sorry, hypertonic solution, mannitol. It is given. Third, fourth one is the hypotonic solution. 0.3% NS. 0.3% NS. It is used in the osmotic fragility test in hereditary spherocytosis, hereditary spherocytosis, spherocytosis. Because this solution is hypotonic, in this solution, the RBC fragility occurs easily in hereditary spherocytosis, while normal RBCs do not rupture in this hypotonic solution. So it is a osmotic fragility test in hereditary spherocytosis. So these are the clinical applications related with osmosis. Edema, isotonic solution, hypertonic solution in cerebral edema, and hypotonic solution in hereditary spherocytosis. And last type is filtration. It is a mechanical pressure gradient. It is dependent on mechanical pressure gradient, which force the fluid to flow from the higher pressure area to lower pressure area. What is the filtration? It is because of mechanical pressure gradient. It is pressure gradient from high pressure to low pressure. The solutes along with the fluid moves from the area of high pressure to low pressure. The pressure development in body, it is due to cardiac activity, or it is known as cardiac output, then gravity, then vascular tone. It is responsible for development of high pressure, and it is important in transport of nutrition and water to the tissues via the capillaries. It is responsible for capillary flow of blood through the capillaries from high pressure area to low pressure area. Okay, so filtration, it is important in capillaries for transport of nutrition. Second one, it is important in glomerular filtration. So it is important in urine formation. It is important in urine formation. Mean it is important in removal of waste from the body via the kidneys. Filtration. So it is mechanical pressure in filtration. So these are the four main types of passive transport. So keep watching. Thank you.